join me in a spirit of prayer. And as I say, let us pray to the Lord, I invite you to respond, Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, who spins the universe and moves us through time, we seek your presence, though it is already before us. We seek the knowledge of you in an intimate way, a way that shows us your love and your faith and your hope for humanity. We offer now these prayers that weigh on our hearts and many more that go unspoken. For the unity of the church in witness and proclamation of the gospel, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the peace and stability of all peoples and for the leaders of the nation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the places of work, education, and leisure, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a blessing on our homes, for our relations and friends and all whom we love, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the sick and suffering and all who minister to their needs, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those affected by natural disasters and who face suffering as they recover, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and protection of God. In Jesus' name, amen. I offer you now our scripture from Romans 12, 9 through 21. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil, hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection, outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lack in zeal, be ardent in the spirit. Serve the Lord, rejoice in hope, be patient in suffering. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of all the saints and extend hospitality to the strangers. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse them. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be haughty, but associate with the lowly. Do not claim to be wiser than you are. Do not repay anyone evil for evil, but take thought for what is noble in the sight of all. If it is possible, so far as it depends on you, live peaceably with all. Beloved, never avenge yourselves, but leave room for the wrath of God, for it is written, vengeance is mine. I will repay, says the Lord. No, if your enemies are hungry, feed them. If they are thirsty, give them something to drink. For by doing this, you will heap burning coals on their head. Do not be overcome by evil, but overcome evil with good. The word of God for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
Hello! Welcome to the town. My name is Sophia, and I am your tour guide this morning.
Tour.
Tour. That's how we say it around here.
Woman.
I understand that you all are interested in becoming residents here, and so I've been asked to give you the deluxe tour, which will begin with visiting the school. We will then take a trip to the library, and our tour will end in the town square at the Death Tree. And there I will tell you the town rules. Don't worry, friends. I know it sounds ominous, but you don't need to be concerned. for, arrangements can be made. Moving here will change your life. Moving is what this town does best. Now, if you will follow me, the town is in development. In 33, our founder and his closest friends had a conversation, and that discussion, well, it led to our little town. We were born. You see, the town is not like other towns. People here are, well, you know, the truth of the matter is, they're not any different than other people. They're just the same as the people you meet in San Francisco and Baton Rouge and Tampa. But here, our town, well, it's the relationships that are different. They're extraordinary. In fact, we joke that our relationships aren't normal, they're paranormal. You guys are a tough crowd. Well, here we go. I want to welcome you to the school. This is the school, Fellowship K-12. This lovely brick building went up way before my time. In fact, I went to kindergarten here.
Come on.
Wonderful place.
Isn't it beautiful? I spent the best 14 years of my life at this school. Just kidding. Okay, notice the yard. Oh my goodness, look. There's Talia and her friend Sammy. Oh, it looks like Sammy's upset. Sammy's been crying, I think. Huh. I wonder why Sammy's feeling sad. And Talia is listening, holding her. She looks like she's ready to cry herself. Sitting there with her arm around Sammy and listening to her pour her heart out, I think it's helping. Well, that's just one example, folks. Nice work, girls. Talia is following the rules. All right, let's walk on now. Around the back of the school, you can see that the track team is having a meet. These students are amazing athletes. They do amazing things. I'm really proud of them. Why, they're great residents of the town, too. Oh, look at that. Now, isn't that interesting? It's Cheryl Johnson. Looks like she's hurt her ankle again. That girl's got the weakest ankles you ever did see. But look, Sienna Brown, she has stopped running. Why, Sienna has decided to help pick Cheryl up and carry her across the finishing line. My goodness. Good job, Sienna. Sienna lost the race. So did Cheryl. I guess it didn't matter that much to her. Although she's been practicing for a long time, that girl doesn't do anything but run and occasionally eat a Twinkie. Strange. Well, you know, she's following the rules. She's got to follow those rules. We can learn so much from our young folks, can't we? All right, come on with me, folks. Now, I can see by the glaze in your eyes that you're starting to get bored with the track meet, so let's move on. We're walking. Now, I want to remind you as we head over to the library that the things you're seeing might make you feel warm in your heart area, but that doesn't mean that's why I'm showing them to you. I mean, they might make you feel good, but the town is not about feelings. I'm going to say that again because some of you might not understand my accent. The town is not about feelings. It's not. Like Sienna each other like human beings. I know it's a strange concept, but to treat each other like human beings, and then they follow the rules, and they're both happy about it. Strange thing, I know. You'll get used to it eventually. You know, their whole thing is about making each other better people. Better people. That's what the rules are about. But look, time to go around back at the library. Back wrong direction. There we go, it's Joe and June. They've been working together for a while now. I bet you're wondering how anything gets done around here. Well, Joe and June get a lot done. They feed anyone who's hungry. They put together these beautiful meals and then they hand them out at the library because that's where hungry people tend to hang out. I don't know if you knew that. Something about books makes people famished. They feed everybody. Nobody gets turned away. We're like that in this town. Everybody gets fed. Everybody gets taken care of. We had someone once passing through. That guy really wore June out. I mean, he was pretty mean to her. He called her some nasty names. But she fed him. She made sure he had a roof over his head. Did everything she could to make sure that man had what he needed for living. And she lived peaceably with him. That's the way the founder taught us to be. We're almost to the town square now. I bet you're wondering what this town is about. Well, with the rules in place, we get things done. Everything gets taken care of. It works well. Now it's time to go see the death tree. You ready? I think you're ready. It's just around the corner. Think about how it feels to be part of our town. So nice, everybody cares about you, interested in you becoming a better person, following the founder's rules. The death tree and the rules, they keep us in line. That's why we behave the way we do. Oh, there it is. Here it is, the tree of life. What's that? Oh, no. It's the death tree before. But now that we've come to it, now that you've come to it, it's the tree of life. It is our life. Not death. The tree is here to remind us that we're to overcome evil with good. It's like the one who founded our community. When we follow him, we take up his identity. And we let go of everything else. We become like him. Come, I'll show you a sculpture of him. Oh, there he is. It's just one version of him. He looks awful clean to me. I never saw him look that clean. It's Jesus, you know. He's the one we follow. He's the one whose name we take as our own. Talia comforting her friend Sammy. That was Talia being Jesus. Sienna helping Cheryl across the finish line. That was her being Jesus. Charles and Lola playing cards together, that was them being Jesus. Joe and June feeding people was being Jesus. He's the one who taught us how to follow the rules. All right, I think you're ready, folks. Are you ready for the town rules? Do you want to be part of this town? Okay, get out of pan. I'm not kidding. Get out of pan. You'll want to write this down. It's important. comes down to that. Well, that concludes our tour. I hope you had a good day.
Didn't she just say four? Well, yeah.
Join me in prayer. Loving God, make us part of your community. Hold us in your arms. Teach us to follow your Son, so that we may show the kind of love you implore us to show. Remind us that you seek hearts that are open to love, that you seek mercy and kindness instead of sacrifice and power. Move your people, Lord, for the healing of your world, so that racism and violence, hatred and ugliness, oppression and starvation are no longer issues.